Hey guys, so I decided to make this makeup video and I decided to do it a bit more professional this time with a bunch of editing, a voiceover on top, some music. So if you guys want to learn how to do this sunset type look, then you should definitely keep on watching. Ignore all my little silly antics, my stuttering, and my stuffed voice. That would be great. So here I am, I've already prepped and primed off camera. I didn't know that it wasn't recording. So I started with my NYX Photo Loving Primer, as well as I used Benefit the Pore Professional, and that's just to minimize my pores. Now I'm gonna go in with my NYX High Definition Eyeshadow Base, and I'm just gonna put a little dot on each eye and rub it in with my finger. Now we're gonna go in with my MAC Pro Longwear Paint Pot in Soft Okra, and this is just to give everything a nice neutral base. And now I'm being silly. Today we're going to be using mainly the Radioactive Melt Set. So we're going to be using Neon, Radon, and Radioactive. We're also going to be using the Mavita Loca palette by Kat Von D, and I'm going to be going in with Molder. Sorry, I'm going to be going in with Noble, actually. And that's just going to be a base color. So we're gonna go in with my NYX 16 brush, which is a crease brush, and get that all over the crease in the lid. Going back in with that same brush, we're gonna get on Neon and just take that in through the crease and above the crease. And make sure you really blend it nicely. Going in with my MAC 217 brush, I'm gonna go over that and just blend it all out. This is a blending brush. Now going back in with my NYX 16 brush, I'm going to be taking Radon, this beautiful orange color, getting it nicely on there. And I'm gonna take that right into the crease. I still want the yellow to be visible, which is pretty important if you want this sunset thing going on. Now I'm gonna go back into my crease using a Morphe B83 brush, and I'm gonna put that Radon orange color right on there and put it right through the crease. And I'm going to, after that's all applied, blend that out again using my blender brush from MAC. Going back in with the yellow, which is called Neon, I just wanted to reapply that, make it brighter. Now going in with the brightest color, this is pink, called Radioactive, I'm going in with my Morphe B83 and I'm dabbing this on. It's important to press this pigment onto your lid, don't swipe right away, to get it really packed onto your lid. And I'm going back in with my NYX 16 and I'm going to blend that so there's no harsh lines. At this point I realized my color wasn't bright enough, so I wanted to really pack the orange back in. So I went back in with my Morphe B83 brush right into the crease with that orange. And then blended the crease using my NYX 16 brush. In doing so, I lost some of the pink color, so I wanted to go back on and pack that in again, just so that everything had the depth I was looking for. It's up to you how deep you want it. I just like it to be really packed on and colorful. Again, taking my crease brush. I don't know what I did then, but anyway. Going in with my Morphe B83, I'm gonna take this pink Radioactive color all under my waterline. I'm gonna line my entire base of my eye, and then I'm gonna go ahead and blend that out using my blending MAC 217 brush. Just blending that all together. Now I'm going in with my NYX eyeliner, which is in Jet Black, and I'm gonna take this all along my waterline. And I'm going to smudge that once it's on my waterline using a pencil brush. And now I'm dancing, for being clear. I had to sharpen my pencil and reapply it. Didn't like it the way it came out when it was unsharpened. So now the eyes are done. We're gonna move on to my face. This is NYX's Dark Circle Corrector, so I'm just taking a normal concealer brush, layering that under my dark circles, which I tend to have quite heavy dark circles. Using a beauty blender, I'm just gonna blend everything out using small little dabs, and then I also wanna kinda create the shape of my eyes. So using the concealer, I can wipe away shadows that have fallen and kind of create the look I'm looking for. Now I'm using NYX's HD Concealer Wand, I can't tell you the color because I've stopped using this product and I am now using MAC Concealer in NW15. I'm also just going to go over any red spots I see and blend it out with my beauty blender. This thing is a godsend. Ever since I started using a beauty blender, I can't use anything else. Now I'm going in with IT Cosmetics' concealer, and this is in medium. Now this is quite wet, so a little bit goes a long way. And like I said, I really put stuff under my eyes. Now I'm going to set everything using e.l.f. High Definition Under Eye Setting Powder. I have no idea if this is necessary, but I do like the way you make it looks and feel. Now we're going to go ahead and use Hoola by Benefit, and I use this to kind of contour my cheeks. It comes off very dark, but when you blend it all together and you use like a powder concealer over it, it definitely comes out the way I expect it to. So I'm going to use this on my cheekbones. And I'm also going to frame the sides of my face and the base of my chin. So going all around, we want to frame my entire face using Hoola, and as well as the top of my head. So if you have a big forehead, you would probably want to take this down more. So I'm just doing it right on the tip. Now I'm just using a Bare Minerals brush. I use any brushes I find, really. And I'm just going to blend that all into my skin. And you'll notice that it's definitely not as dark anymore. Now I'm going to go in with Rockateur by Benefit as well, which is a blush. And I'm just using a Makeup Forever blush brush, and I'm just going to put that onto my cheeks and wipe it up. Now I'm going to use MAC Studio Fix, and this is in NW20. And I'm just using a powder brush to wipe this all on. This is why I do my Hoola on the bottom, so that I can layer this on top. Now I'm going to do my eyeliner. So I'm using Kat Von D's Tattoo Liner, and I'm mixing that in with NYX's liner as well, both in black. I struggled to do my eyeliner. I started to do it on camera, and it was going well, and then it was just really hard to do. So you can see me starting it on camera, but I had to go off camera to finish both of my eyes. It was just so stressful. Eyeliner is incredibly stressful. So here I've got the one eye. And all of a sudden I've got my two, and they don't match. They never will. That's just the thing with eyeliner. It just happens. There's nothing you can do about it. Like, I really like this eye, but not this eye. This eye's great. Now I'm going in with Too Faced's Better Than Sex Mascara. This mascara is great. Now I'm gonna backcomb my lashes because I've got a lot of product on there, the color, and then I'm going to pull them up and kind of feather them through. I don't wear fake lashes. So it's important that like my lashes kind of look the best, and this mascara is the bomb. Now I'm gonna do my eyebrows. So I'm going in with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Definer in Ebony. I'm gonna comb them upwards and then start to draw it through. Once I feel like I have a good shape, I'm going to take my Sephora eyebrow brush, which is actually a winged liner brush, an angled liner brush, but I'm just going to put that in Anastasia Beverly Hills pomade in Ebony, and I'm just going to line my brows and really define them. Trying to get this fade-in look, which is really hard, you want to have barely any product on. Eyebrows and lips are still something I'm really struggling with. Now I'm gonna go in with Kat Von D's Everlasting Liquid Lipstick in Exorcism. I love all her products, especially her liquid lipsticks. So I'm gonna go ahead first and kind of cover the majority of my lips. Now I'm still struggling with lipstick. It always kind of comes out blotchy. So I've gotten this MAC 316 lip brush, and it really helps me to kind of get a really clean look. And then I'm just gonna touch it back up with her liquid lipstick. Now I'm using Soft and Gentle Highlighter by MAC. And I'm using an angled brush, and I'm gonna go ahead and dip that through and put it on my above my cheekbones and on my nose, on my chin, just a little bit. And that's it. Kind of simple, but really, really aggressive looking. I really like this look a lot, and I hope you guys enjoy it too.